So earlier we got a quick recap or introduction to conduction as a first mode of heat transfer, and conduction was guided by Fourier's law. So we'll now go into the details of Fourier's law. So a bit of clarification, in earlier I may have used Q as the rate of heat transfer because generally Q and Q dot are not distinguished anywhere in the literature. Generally Q is used as rate of heat transfer, but for convention of ours, Q will be heat transferred, that is the amount of heat transfer, or that is having a unit of energy or joules. Q dot is the rate of heat transfer, small q, which is heat flux. I'll define heat flux in a moment. T is temperature, small t is time, x or along with y and z will be spatial coordinates, k is called as thermal conductivity. I'll define the small k in some moment. A is area, or I'll say perpendicular area. Right. So let's go to Fourier's law. So what it says? It says that heat flux is directly proportional to temperature gradient. So dT by dx was temperature gradient. This is temperature gradient for us. Now heat flux is symbolized as small q, and it is dT by dx. Now that small q which I said is the total amount of rate of heat transfer upon the area. So just to give you some analogy, if the rate of heat transfer was 100 units, we'll go to the units of what are the specific units, but let's use 100, and then let's say we have 10,000 units. These are the two possibilities. But over here, if the area is 100, if the area is 1 unit, and over here the area is 1000 units, this means that my Q will be 100 over in this case, and in this case my Q will be 10,000 over 1000, that means Q is only 10. So it may look like that the rate of heat transfer is higher over here, because the quantity is larger, but that rate of heat transfer is happening from a larger area, that is 1000 units of area. So the heat flux or the strength of that heat, rate of heat transfer, is smaller compared to this case where we have Q is equal to 100. So basically that heat flux is a normalized kind of rate of heat transfer. We are normalizing it with respect to the area available. So let's come back over here. So we had Q, small q, which is directly proportional to dT by dx. Hence, we'll have Q dot upon area proportional to dT by dx. Hence, Q dot will be proportional to A dT by dx. Now to remove the proportionality, we'll need a proportionality constant. So this K is the proportionality constant for us. So this is the formula. Now let's look at this dT by dx term. So that dT is usually defined as final temperature minus the initial temperature. But if we are given with some wall, let's say this is a wall, brick wall, and we are given with temperatures at T1 and T2. So usually we'll write them as T1 minus T2. Whenever we are making some formula, etc. So what I'll do, I'll change this dT as minus dT is equal to T1 minus T2. And now I'll use this over here just to simplify. So my formula will be Q dot will be equal to minus KA T1 minus T2 over dx. This is a simple modification. There is no much change. This is just T1 to bring it in terms of T1 minus T2. That's the main aim. Otherwise, this is what it is. So that's only to differentiate it with respect to the direction. That's why. Because dx will count in this direction. That's why I have taken t1 minus t2 in that direction. Otherwise, there is no much difference. So let me define some more thing. So this was the heat flux, and heat generation will be Qgen or Q double dot. So we'll come to that at some later stage, but just to give you some small introduction, that's why it's not required right now. So that's all. This is the Fourier's law, and we'll look at the units quickly. So we already know the unit of Q as watt, because that is the rate of heat transfer, so that is watt. K we don't know, so we want to find out the units of K. Area has a unit of meters squared. Temperature has units of Kelvin, and the distance has units of meter. So this gives me the unit of K as watts per meter Kelvin. So this is the unit of K, thermal conductivity, watt per meter Kelvin. Now we already know that for temperature scale, Kelvin and degree Celsius are directly related. That means they have a scalar difference between them. So we can change this unit with watt per meter degree Celsius also, and there will be nothing wrong to say if my thermal conductivity is 25 watts per meter Kelvin, or that is same as 25 watts per meter degree Celsius. But we cannot change them to Fahrenheit. That will be a wrong thing. We cannot directly change it to Fahrenheit. So Kelvin and degree Celsius doesn't matter. At any point of time, we can enter T1 and T2 as Kelvin or as degree Celsius. But obviously T1 and T2 both should be in the same units. We cannot have them in different units. So that's all. In next video, we'll look at some things which are, we'll go into details of this thermal conductivity. So we'll find out the factors or dependencies of K. This is our topic for next video. Okay, thank you.